Hey Scorpio, how are you all? Welcome to the season of eclipses and therefore welcome to the sacred sage. In case you're new to my channel, I am so happy that you discovered us and I hope that you kind of get some relevant messages through our readings. Please note that these are general readings, so do not forget to check your sun sign, moon sign, and rising sign. And those of you all who are in love and know where Venus is placed in your chart, you may also go and check the readings for those signs, because no matter how hard I try, there is always a love message and a twin flame message in all my readings. Now, we are in this time of a huge energy shift, especially because of these eclipses. This is going to be the last lunar eclipse of the Leo eclipse season, which started sometime in 2016. So which means roughly around 3 years, everything that these eclipses have brought into your life, that cycle is ending. Now, it could mean different things for different people. For a few of you all, it may be about your professional life. And for a few, it could also be purely spiritual. It may just mean spiritual evolution. For the others of you, maybe it is to do with your love life or your personal relationships, right? So career, love, personal evolution, irrespective of what it is the ending of that cycle, right? So whatever it brings along, it brings along. There's nothing that you can do except accepting it, knowing it, being aware, and therefore moving forward on your spiritual path. Scorpio, especially for you, I do see a huge tower moment coming in. So yes, it's going to be a moment of truth, a moment of revolution, moment where everything that does not serve you is going to just go shackling down. And I don't know what happens to that. Right. I do know that it's going to be a moment of heartbreak for you. And I'm definitely not going to sugarcoat my words. It is about something or some aspect of your life where you probably believed in something or believed a few people and you were just going with the flow without knowing if it is in your highest best to be on the path that you are. Right. And maybe eclipse after eclipse, something about it was being told to you. And if you were wise enough to get those signals, then yes, it'll be easy for you to handle this situation. In case you did not read the messages right, then definitely, yes, there is a tower moment and it will speak for itself. You will have a moment of heartbreak that is going to make you sad. But hey, you know what? It's going to force you to think and to connect with your higher self. Right. It will definitely bring about that spiritual connection that you badly need, not just with the universe, but first with your own self. It somehow feels as if you were blindfolded. It somehow feels as if you were very ignorant about your own soul purpose. And that is the reason why you've been in the situations that you've been. This tower moment leads you to a space where you will have to, in your sacred soul space, connect with yourself and try find these answers as to why is it that it happened to you. And the moment you do that, answers will be revealed to you. The universe will help you and guide you walk through this path. And there will be the moment of judgment right after. Now, when we say judgment, it's not just about punishments for those who did wrong. It's also about what is it that you as a soul did to do justice to your own soul journey. What I can figure out as a clarifier is that this moment of judgment definitely brings in a lot of balance. Now, it may not resonate with each one of you because this is a generic reading. However, if I dig deeper into your situation, I believe that this is to do with your personal equation and your finances. Each one to his own. However, what comes out in the reading is that there has been a man, someone whom you considered as the King of Cups. So maybe you were also romantically inclined to this person, or it could be possible that the person was romantically inclined to you and you thought that this whole romantic connection is also going to bring in security from a financial perspective. Because there's something about money over there, right? So whether you got involved with this person because of money, or whether this person probably comes with that emotional and financial security that, irrespective of it coming with its own challenges, you accepted this relationship. Something about that is definitely coming to an end. Yeah. So because it's an imbalanced equation and you know it, right? Either it is not the purest form of love and it is love for a reason, whether it is money or security or a void within yourself or your own lack of self-love. The reason for you being in this equation with this person whom you consider as the King of Cups is not divine love, right? Now, I'm not saying that the equation breaks. If you are in this equation and you've been going through a lot because of your own lack of self or lack of self-esteem, then this tower moment is going to tell you about all the lessons that you need to learn for your own self-worth and self-love and self-esteem. If you're in this equation because money, then you definitely got to learn that divine love is not about material abundance or material assets. Right. So some truth is being revealed, lessons to be learned. Yes, you do feel sad, you feel left out and you feel lonely and you will have a moment of conflict, right? Whether it is your own internal battle with your own thoughts. There is this whole struggle that you will have to go through thanks to the eclipse energy. But as a resultant, what comes out is balance. As a result, what I also see is that there is someone else, right? Someone who is probably naive or younger to you, could also be another water sign. Someone comes to make an offer. This person, I would say, I wouldn't just call it a romantic offer or a soulmate equation just as yet. However, there is an offer, there is an opportunity, there is somebody who is very tender, innocent at heart, who's going to stand beside you, make an offer, and probably help you feel better while you go through these energy shifts. And I think it's also possible that the person is already there and known to you. The person may have communicated or at least made their first move and are waiting for you to respond. They've done their bit in case they've already entered your life. And for those of you who are still feeling lonely, there is a possibility that somebody comes in. But however it plays out, all that I have to say is this whole cycle of the drama, the materialism, a love for wealth or love for a reason, which is your own lack of self-worth, the moment it shatters, the new person or the new love that you experience now on in life is going to be something which is your own manifestation, because it is in every possible way, a wish coming true. And this new love or new person, not only is he or she worthy of your love, I would also say that the security that you've been seeking, this is the one who will bring you that emotional and financial security. So if you can gather yourself and move out of this karmic setup that you're in, then true love, companionship, and well-being is waiting right on the other side of these eclipses for you. Before I end the reading, I only want to tell you that be careful around the eclipse, which is on the 21st for major part of the world. And for those who stay in the other side of the hemisphere, you may just experience this energy on the 22nd. Not always do you experience this during the eclipse time, right? It's common for people to feel heavy, emotional, slightly frustrated or restless 2 or 3 days before and after the eclipse. However, if it goes smoothly for you, the eclipse and the shift that it is supposed to bring in can manifest itself even around 2 to 3 months after the eclipse. So it slowly plays out. Whatever its plan of action is for you, it plays out slowly for a few of you all. So be conscious of the fact that you are in the times of change, and therefore be more accepting of the change and of your own self as you evolve as an individual and as a soul in 2019. I wish you all the best and hope you sail through the eclipses safely and soulfully. Take care.